National Federation of the Blind. Live the life you want through science, technology, engineering, and math. Tactile drawing.
My name is Ann Cunningham, and I am the art teacher at the Colorado Center for the Blind. And I've been invited out here to the EQ program this week to teach orthographic perspective and isometric perspective for engineering drawing. I'd like to run through some of the tools, that we've modified a little bit so that the students are able to create tactile drawings. So the first one is this tactile drafting board. It's a regular drafting board that we put a sensational blackboard on the surface so that we can now put paper on it. And when we draw with a regular pen, this is regular paper, and we draw with a regular pen, we have a tactile line that we can feel. One of the next tools that we have that we've modified is a regular 30-60-90 triangle that we use for the isometric perspective. And I've notched it along each of the edges at a 1-inch increment. So the 1-inch is to extend from the bottom up of the 90, both sides of the 90, and then from the 30 degree up to the 60, since the 30 degree is more important than the 60 degree in isometric perspective. We're also using a regular compass with a wheel adjustment so that we can hold it steady without it readjusting while we're drawing with it. When we're using the regular pointed tip, but we're allowing the lead to break so it's not a real sharp point, so that when we're drawing on the paper on the blackboard, it's wide enough to create the dotted line. Here's a piece of paper, and I'd like you to just tape it down on the board. So Logan's just positioning the paper. The paper sticks to the board a little bit, so it is sometimes a little difficult to move, but that's helpful so that your paper isn't sliding all over the place. I don't know what size this cube is, but we can say it's a 3-inch cube. Would you? So if you just draw a 3-inch cube, that would be great. Thanks. All right, so here's your perspective. We're gonna draw the front and the left and right side views, and include the top view also.
Logan examines the 3D cube.
So what are you gonna start with? Okay.
Logan positions the 90-degree angle of the triangle against the horizontal bar of the drafting board, finds the 3-inch notch, and draws a line down from the notch to the bar. To draw the bottom left edge of the cube, she places the point of the 30-degree angle at the bottom of the original line with the triangle to the left of the line.
Now what are you doing?
I'm drawing the bottom left edge.
Can you point that out on the box? Yep.
To draw the right bottom edge, Logan flips the triangle so that the point of the 30-degree angle is still at the bottom of the original line, but the triangle is to the right of the line. Logan then moves to draw the back edges of the sides of the cube by drawing two parallel lines that meet the ends of the bottom edge lines she drew.
The other side. So is that, what line is that one? Well, okay, you drew this one?
Line.
Yeah, we want to draw that line, right?
Yes.
So this line is already drawn.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So you're going to find that other corner. Now, what's next? We need to draw the top line, right?
Yes.
For the top of each side. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Logan uses the 30-degree angle of the triangle again to draw the front edges of the top of the cube by drawing a connecting line from the top of each parallel line to the top of the original center line.
Okay. That'd be pretty good. Yeah. We're gonna make some connections trying to get down there. Great.
Logan shows off the final cube drawing.
And that's how blind people do STEM. For more information, visit blindscience.org.